And when I rolled into the kind of to the parade finish, I was looking around like, what are all these people here for, right? I thought it was a different event happening or somebody famous was here. And then I realized, oh my God, this is for me, right?
Canadian Leah Goldstein is the ultimate road warrior. She just cycled in an event called Race Across America, which is known as the toughest bicycle race in the world, and it's over 5,000 kilometers long. The twist? You have to do it in less than 12 days. Goldstein made history this year. She did it in 11 days, 3 hours, and 30 minutes, not only winning the race, but she became the first female to win it in its 39-year history.
So it was crazy. Like, it's indescribable. Like I said, it so wasn't expected, but what a bonus, you know, not just for myself, but kudos to my crew.
The race is one of the most physically challenging in the world. It's over 11 days straight of cycling. And on top of that, the 52-year-old was racing across America in one of the worst heat waves the country has experienced in its history.
The outside of my body took the most damage, right? Because I even got burnt through my jersey when they went to change me on a, you know, because we get changed every 8 hours. My back was blistered and burnt, and that went right through my shirt, and my arms were blistered and burnt. I mean, because, you know, you're constantly dousing yourself with water in order to cool your core temperature, and that water is washing away all sunscreen and everything. So you can imagine how you're being baked for a week, you know, on the bike, right?
In the 267 hours it took her to complete the race, she only rested for a total of 21 hours.
You know, like, you have 12 days to get across the country. So how we did it is, like, the first 40 hours I rode without a sleep break. And then I started taking my breaks of 3 hours every 24 hours, right? And then at, like, the last 3 days, we had to cut it down to 90 minutes.
On a lack of sleep, in sweltering heat, and physically exhausted, Goldstein says there are moments during the race that the mental game is the hardest to play.
Because you start to hallucinate. A lot of times I didn't know what I was doing on the bike. I didn't know why my crew was behind me. So, you know, you're kind of in this la-la land until you actually get to the finish, you know, and then things start to really sink in, right? But all you know when you're riding is that you have to get across the country. You got to get to that finish line.
I know. You're all probably wondering the same thing I am. Why? Why would anybody do this?
It's just like an ultimate high, you know, especially with Race Across America. That's been on my radar since I was a little kid. It's a completely different beast every time you do it, right? So it's the challenge, I think, that really drives me to it.
For City News, I'm Lindsay Dunn.